Whether in our own backfields or burning savannah plains, some kid will build a rope swing on a brook that has no name.
It's kind of the bridging song, really, between the last album and the new one, and it's probably the only one that was written out of sync with the rest of it. I was invited to do a track for a compilation album, which was all about the fate of elephants in the wild. Something that I was interested in, very happy to be invited to do. It was all to do with a book that was published by a wildlife photographer called Leslie Wood. And she invited quite a lot of artists to make this compilation album with a different track all about the fate of the elephant on it. Steve Hackett was one of the people who did it, label mate of ours, and several other artists contributed to this multimedia package. It wasn't a tangent track, it was just something that was under my own name. But over the course of the time after doing it, I played the track to Luke. Luke had quite a lot to say about it and liked it and thought we could include it with the tangent music. So we did a different version of it, and that became the starting point. We started to do the non-political stuff on this record, really.
Immediately hooked with that track. Gorgeous, gorgeous song. Just the whole structure of it is just really, really well written. It's just one of those tracks that really pulls at the heartstrings and the lyrical content and everything. And the melodies in it are so rich, and it's really something that grabbed me immediately. It's a gorgeous, gorgeous song, and obviously incorporating some acoustic guitars to it, and Mario's voice and Jonas, you know, fluid fretless bass work and stuff like that. It's just, you know,
it was just a solo track before, but yeah, I was pleased about the way that particular song went, because it's always been kind of a little ambition to write a prog epic that's quite short. In fact, you know, that 7 minute song, 7 minutes is quite long to most people, but to us prog rock people it's quite a short song. And trying to write what we would normally put into a 20 minute song and really condensing it into what the Beach Boys call a pocket symphony, you know, was quite a challenge, and because that's what we had to do for this compilation album. In the end, really, really pleased with the song, and I love the new version, and I think it was a great idea to pursue it as a tandem piece. Okay, Dr. Livingston, I presume, was, if you want to know why the title is the title, this is all to do with my illness, which has happened between now and the last album. We spoke about it earlier, but for a little while after I was ill, I lost my mojo. It was as if I couldn't find the person that I was to actually write the music. So I stopped writing music, did a few other things and everything. And then gradually, slowly but surely, I decided I was going to try and find my mojo, if you know what I mean. Try to find that spark that makes me write the songs. And it was almost like the quest of Speke, the famous explorer, going off to find Dr. Livingstone, and eventually finding him halfway up the Nile. And Mark Buckingham, the artist, has done a really nice picture of me meeting up with myself. But the great thing was is that this came through as an instrumental, and I've had this partnership with Luke, which has lasted a long time, you know, in the great scheme of things. And I'd never written a piece that was just for Luke to play. And that was a really nice place to start, to actually sort of come back and start writing music again and have something to offer to somebody else and say, what can you do with this?
Well, the first time I heard it, it was just this long, beautiful, constructed guitar line. And I had to go at it the first couple of tries, and I was like, it just falls under the finger so well, because the way that you kind of write composition that isn't on the guitar, it's like it's a guitar sound but on keyboard and stuff, but it just falls under the fingers so nicely, and the construction of the piece is so well written, and there's some absolutely stunning, gorgeous little set, like jazz sections in there, you know, it goes from this big, proud kind of progressive rock, all our, you know, guitar at the helm kind of section, and into weaves in and out of beautiful little jazz, you know, pieces and stuff. And there's a little flavour in the middle that's absolutely stunning. You know, it's possibly one of my favourite tangent bits. It's gorgeous, absolutely stunning. But, just, you know, the whole dynamics of the track, it just really comes down, and it's just the placement of the chords rhythmically and stuff. It's just really, really nice. And then after that, it just builds up and fireworks happen in the middle, you know.
This was the first one I've done, you know. It wouldn't have been the same piece without Lou, and it certainly wouldn't be the same piece without me. So we wrote this piece together, and I'm very happy with it. And the fact that it's an instrumental,
yeah,
probably the first one of these that we've actually done to any large degree, because there's been plenty of instrumental work.
This is the first self-contained, start-to-finish instrumental that we've ever done. So. Yeah.